Good evening, I am Kashipur.
Good evening, sir.
I'm so delighted to be here, but very nervous. I'm nervous about this 18-minute timeline, you know, which is clicking in front of me. So I don't know whether I'll be reaching this 18-minute deadline or exceeding it. So if I ever get an opportunity to come here again, so if I exceed, you can subtract it next time. And if I do not reach it, so give me extra minutes. It is indeed an honor to have been invited here to share my personal and professional journey at TEDx platform at IIM Kashipur, and also of identifying UP Police Twitter Seva as a potential agent of shaping the future. Now, before I start talking about this most revolutionary exercise in social media undertaken by any police organization in this country, I would like to reiterate certain factors from my life, because all of you are youngsters, aspiring youngsters, want to be inspired. So those factors which have brought a small police officer like me from the largest police force of the world to be at a TEDx platform. So as every struggler's life, my life also has been a mix of struggle and dream life. Dream life because its latest destination is IIM Kashipur and a TEDx platform. So to begin with, my life has been more or less D for driven, which is again driven by a couple of more dreams, a couple of more D's. So the first D for me has been dreams. Now, you nurture a dream, all of you youngsters, my message to you is that nurture a dream and chase it unless you finally achieve it. Now, ever since my childhood, I'd always dreamt that if I'll be in a government job, I'll only be a police officer and nothing else. This was not so for the power or the glamour of the uniform, as you might be imagining. But because I'd seen my father and grandfather as police officers, you know, utilizing this uniform, donning it with a lot of pride, and also seeing it as a department, as a job which has the potential to deliver instant justice. No other job in this world offers you the potential to deliver instant justice. You're next to God. So I realized the power, the medium of this job to do things which would be very positive. Apart from being a police officer, I've nurtured other dreams too. So the message implicit is that do not rest on your laurels. I've also wanted to be a journalist and also a small-time filmmaker. You might be seeing on the slide, I'm lucky enough to be graced to debut with Tapsee Pannu, Ajay Devgan, Sanjay Mishra and a couple of other film stars. So these are some small short films which I have produced, scripted. And if you give me an opportunity next time, I'll show these short films to you. The second D is, you know, dedication to achieve those dreams. And for me, dreams have been always non-negotiable. I can never compromise. When I was a child in school, I lost my father when he was only 41. And on compassionate grounds, I was offered the job of a sub-inspector. No, but I wanted to enter the department on my own terms at an officer's level, considering the fact that my family was under tremendous financial hardships. But I realized that there is no dream without a struggle, and there is no police officer who chooses the easy way out. So I decided to fight it out. I politely refused that job which was offered to me on compassionate grounds, and not only me, three younger brothers of mine also refused the job. And the struggle went on for 9 years before I finally got him where I wanted to be. The third D is a death-defying determination, a determination which is death-defying. When I say death-defying, it seems very idealistic, but I'm quoting some personal life examples. Sorry for using personal life examples, but I'm doing it to make it sound realistic and achievable. You know, I'd achieved my dream job, but often my intention to deliver instant justice was clashing with miscreants and criminals in UP. And the history of crime and criminals in UP is no secret to anyone. But I've always loved chasing these criminals and challenging them, even at the cost of having a close brush with death so many times. 2006, Allahabad. I was posted in Allahabad, you know, in a face-off with gangsters who had come to kill another criminal there. They bombed a head constable of mine, they bombed him to death in broad daylight. In a gun battle which lasted for an hour, we managed to arrest one of them, and one of the criminals was killed. This encounter was telecast live on national channels, And as an act of recognition, the department announced out of 12 promotions and gallantry medals for all of us. An year later, one national channel distorted a clip from the encounter and dubbed this encounter, which might be getting played here, as a fake encounter. We were dubbed as murderers. We were dubbed as criminals. And the same department where officers had changed, who were not aware of this development, they pronounced the judgment that this is a cold-blooded murder, we'll lose our jobs and we'll be sent to jail. I didn't lose heart. You know, I fought for 9 years. I've suffered CBCID inquiries, I fought the NHRC inquiry, got my team members exonerated, you know, the entire civil society, human rights activists. I put the facts squarely before them, and since we had a video footage of that, but still it took 9 years, and in the same encounter in which I was being sent to jail in 2007, I was conferred with the President's Medal for Gallantry in 2015. So a gap of 9 years. Thank you. But the story didn't end there. After this encounter, as you've seen in Bollywood movies, the gang leader had escaped from the spot. His man got killed, one got arrested. I got an intercept which I heard it my own self. He was planning a revenge on me. He wanted to kill another criminal in Allahabad. And I was the biggest obstacle. I was foiling every attempt of his. So he planned to avenge the killing and he wanted to kill me. My team members and family members were very worried because this was a gangster who was known for killing policemen. Before this Allahabad incident also, he had fired on policemen. But I was unfazed and I was very confident. I was not at all worried. I assured my team members, you know, to put our acts together. Just keep on working. Don't get afraid. Few months later, you know, as he had planned, we had a face-to-face again. Any guesses what happened? You know, I'm alive, so I'm here. He's left. He was sent to give company to his friend, whom we had sent a few months back, cool his heel and health. So, another instance, when I said death defying determination, 2016 I started the Twitter Seva of UP Police in 2016 March. And in April I was in ICU in a hospital. I started with two men and they were not proficient with the medium. They were not conversant, not familiar with the English language, with the medium of Twitter. But once as a state organization you have rolled out something, there is no going back. It is not dependent on one particular individual. It was the UP Police. You know, I kept on tweeting from ICU, from the operation theater. My family members got my mobile seized. I pleaded with the nurse secretly. She gave me the mobile back. There was not a single day the tweet stopped. You can see it on the screen. So this was the power of conviction and courage. The message is, even if death stares you face to face, don't give a damn. Just say, I have better things to do. Just wait for some time. The fourth D is, to be different, to think different, which you in management call thinking out of the box. You know, after several years of having offline encounters with criminals, I thought, let me do some online encounters. And that's when I thought of shifting it to the online medium, that is the Twitter. You know, after all, as you must realize, and we all have realized, that words can be more lethal than all arms of the world put together. Priyanka is smiling. So, and she is in the trail of words. So, you know, this out-of-the-box thinking, I was looking for a platform. What could be that platform? So I thought, let me join the DGP headquarters as public relations officer. But when I expressed the desire of mine, there was mixed reaction amongst the officers, and they dissuaded me because I was considered out and out a field officer and an encounter specialist. So what will you do here? But I was looking beyond the mainstream. I was thinking out of the box. I was not wanting to work for one district, for one jurisdiction, for one territory. I was wanting to synchronize the efforts of this entire UP police, the largest police force of the world together, you know, which was working at times at cross purposes. So I thought, what could be the best way to synchronize their efforts together? And that's when Twitter rang the bell. So after finally a lot of persuasion, I was allowed to do what I wanted to do. And in March 2016, the walls between citizens of UP police and the police have started crumbling, at least in the online world. And to give you an idea about, you know, let me tell you that this is the largest partnership of Twitter with any government organization across the world. You know, just sample this, you might see it on the screen. We operate with 125 verified Twitter handles in 75 districts. On an average, the UP police account itself receives 2,000 tweets a day. In 2017, we received close to 2.5 lakh to 3 lakh tweets in the year, out of which 73,000 something were actionable tweets. So this is the scale of operation, and if you add the tweets pouring into various districts, it would be a staggering amount. All our, you know, important wings, traffic, railways, the emergency service of UP 100, all of them are on Twitter. They talk to each other like individuals in an automated, seamless manner. There's nobody whom you have to make a call. So that kind of beautiful, you know, synergy is existing in the online world in UP Police. You know, as I move ahead, after having established this infrastructure and this journey of 2 years, in retrospect, if I were to tell you what all we have been able to achieve, the first thing is, you know, it has led to a paradigm shift. Paradigm shift in the way we have bonded with citizens. You know, to voluntarily opt for accountability for any government organization, you know, it's a change in narrative altogether. When I say change in narrative, you know, if you say in UP, you know, now our emergency service UP 100 is also on Twitter. So even in emergency matters, if you tell someone in UP, you know, about this Bollywood stereotype that police always reaches late, no one would believe you. I'll just give you an example. A tweet from an NRI from Singapore, which I've given quite often this example. When his father was being threatened by criminals in UP, the criminal got arrested in 20 minutes of the tweet, and this was a tweet from Singapore. So this, we foiled this Bollywood stereotype and changed the narrative. The second achievement which we've been able to do is, you know, we've started bridging divides. We know that this medium itself is elitist, you know, urban oriented, but we've taken efforts to bridge this rural-urban divide, to bridge this upper caste and, you know, rich and poor divide, this regional divides, because Twitter as a medium, you know, is free of all kinds of biases. What was usually happening, the complaint was that the rich and the powerful are getting hurt at the police stations and the poor people wait outside. So this medium is giving access to people to reach out to us without any fear. And to increase our outreach, we have gone to the rural areas, we have held camps. This has led to creation of Twitter handles by village pradhans, which is a very positive development. And they start tweeting about the problems of rural people and even at times problems which are not related to police. We get tweets about garbage in the village, we get tweets about sanitation, we get tweets about water problem. So we try and see what else can be done and talk to the local police station that you please speak to the SDM or the counterpart and get it resolved. Thirdly, it has led to tremendous amount of, you know, empowerment of people who have come on the medium. You know, just a funny trivia, very amusing example, just to give you, make you understand the power of our tweets. A man bought a mobile from a shopkeeper, new mobile, which turned out to be defective. He kept on pleading to the shopkeeper to return the mobile or give back the money. The shopkeeper kept on harassing him. He tweeted it to us. We tweeted him back to register a complaint. He went to the shop and instead showed him the screenshot of the tweet. And the shopkeeper gave him a new mobile. So now, the message in UP is, thappad se nahi tweet se dar lagta hai. Dande se nahi tweet se dar lagta hai. This is for the empowerment. What has it done for the women? You know, women's security itself is a big problem. You know, I'll give you two examples. A group of college girls who were moving in a train in a district called Gonda. You know, there were 40 odd girls, 40-50 girls, and There were ruffians who went inside, they bolted the compartment, both the doors got bolted, and they started molesting them. Somebody tweeted from the compartment, and on the very next station, 41 of them were arrested. In another incident, the ladies' compartment got captured, somebody tweeted us, the next station they were unseated and fined. There are countless examples of this nature, which has helped the people of the state, which has helped us creating new bonds. All these efforts have incrementally helped us in improving our perception and credibility. When people hear tales that just on a tweet something gets done, so it is also translating in offline credibility and trust for us. People on the ground also believe even these people can help people just on tweets. So let us approach them. Just an example, an 11-year-old boy, he reaches a police station in Itawa and he wants his father to be arrested. This video went viral. And he complained that his father is not taking him to the fair and not giving his family time. In turn, what we did was, 50 of his friends were taken to the fair, they were treated to the ice cream and the entire mela was reserved for them, along with the parents. So this kind of an achievement, you know, in perception and credibility, if a kid can approach a police station, you know, that shows that we perhaps moving in the right direction. Also, you know, it is acting as a goodwill ambassador for us. You know, corporates, you must be hiring brand ambassadors at tremendous amount of cost. But this is acting as a goodwill ambassador. Swiss tourist, another example, Swiss tourists got beaten up in Agra. Though the criminals got arrested who, you know, bashed them, they were boys, they were touts. We started, but the damage to the UP police credibility of the state, of the country was done. They were Swiss tourists. So we started a Get Well Soon campaign for them on Twitter. There were thousands of tweets with a hashtag which poured in. We compiled it in the form of a book and gifted it to the Swiss embassy to be gifted to them. They said that it is an unprecedented gesture of the Suomoto by any police organization across the world. So the time, 1:30. So I'll quickly wrap it up to conclude. You know, my only thing is that social media is no silver bullet. You know, it is just a new way of doing the old business, and old business we have to do. And the message for the citizens is, do not suffer in silence, whichever medium you can, you know, embrace. Please embrace it, please acknowledge our attempt, and voice your grievances, because we are equal stakeholders in the society which we are going to create. Trust us, it is a very brave move for any government organization to make citizens, to give citizens access to us, because citizens at times are very vocal in expression of their discontent. So please join this brigade, and to the reluctant police officers who are still reluctant to come here, to come to this medium, I also, you know, request them that they're working very hard offline. Please join this online battle too. Please listen to citizens, and maybe you're also a very rich police officer like me. Rich not in terms of wealth. I have a huge family on Twitter who stands by me. You know, I am told that amongst my colleagues, I'm the highest followed police officer on an individual account in this country. So this is the message to my colleagues and for all of you. So stay social, fight the antisocials, and I think this is an idea definitely worth spreading. Thank you. Jai Hind.